It's a rough and ready day here in Blackpool. We're at the South Pier. Welcome to UK Theme Parks. My name's Adam, and today we are checking out some of the rides on the pier. To be quite honest, it's been a few years since we've ridden rides on the pier. We've come on here and done a few walk arounds. We rode the crazy coaster a couple of years ago, and of course the breakdance, which I love that breakdance. I know it's not a Huss one, but I do love that breakdance. There's a few rides on here, to be honest with you. There are token options. It's 25 tokens for £20. You can get, I'm just looking at the sign, 80 tokens for £60. I think that's definitely more of a family one. And then tokens range. So it's 2 tokens for juvenile rides, which includes sort of little SeaWorld, little swings. I think as well the carousel is 2 tokens. And then it ranges to 3 tokens for like the Miami, which is the Hard Rock just there, the breakdance over there, and the Dodgems and the Waltzer. And I think it's 4 tokens for the crazy coaster. Pound a token otherwise. So it is definitely better value if you buy more than one token, to be fair. I think the Sky Swinger or the Screamer there is £20, and I think it's the same with this as well. You want to fly right the way off the end of the pier, that is also, I'm sure, £20, but I will double check that. So it's not the cheapest, to be fair. I think the breakdown at £3 is quite reasonable, and obviously if you're getting 25 tokens for £20, it does bring the price down to about £2.60, £2.70 a ride, which isn't too bad. The Hellraiser, I think it's a Hellraiser. I keep getting the Waltzers mixed up. I know someone's going to be hammering me in the comments for calling one Hellraiser the other day when it was Hellblazer or something like that. The Waltzer. The Waltzer's quite a classic one. One we've been on before. It's had some new LED lights. It's probably not one we're going to ride today. Same with the Dodgems and indeed the Overshoulder Restraint Hard Rock. But I do want to get on the breakdance today, and I will probably get on the coaster, that crazy coaster. It's funny, they advertised it as one of the best twisting coasters there was. It's fairly new, it was new when it came on the pier. It must have been about 3 or 4 years ago now. And I will say, it is quick. It is one of the quicker ones we've done. So it'd be nice to get back on it. It's been a couple of years since we went on it. When we came last year, obviously it was just after COVID times. Things weren't functioning just right, but they are definitely, definitely better now. You can see a windy day here at Blackpool, but Pleasure Beach is open, that's in full flow. I can see Skyforce going around, we just seen a big one going around, and indeed Icon. Check out our Blackpool Pleasure Beach vlog if you want to see some from inside the park this October. But we're going to get some tokens now, we're going to take you on a couple of rides. Which one first? I don't know. But we are also, keep an eye out, going to go down to the Central Pier as well. That was damaged by fire last year, just coming out of COVID, I believe. And when we went there, the Matterhorn had been sort of burnt a little bit and the Waltzer had been completely destroyed. So we understand a new Waltzer is there, and indeed the Matterhorn has been, I'm guessing, refurbished. I've been told it's open. So again, look out for that on the channel over the next couple of days. But on to some rides. Where do we start?
They all come in here too, he's got a driving license. Turn the wheel all the way back round and they're all forward in.
Have you
got
the last sash?
Over the sea here, like it's even see-through grates. have to say, for a fairly new coaster, this thing has been battered by the sea. Absolutely battered. But funny, there's one of these at the end of Brighton Pier, and it doesn't, I don't know, doesn't feel quite the same like you're over the water like it does here. Here really feels like there's nothing around you, below you. I remember this thing did spin quite viciously. Oh, yeah. Oh. Us up a bit. Oh, I've sat on things. Oh, it's the seatbelt. Oh my god. Yeah, I remember now. I remember. Yeah, got a bit of a whip to it, I won't lie to you, bit of a whip. Oh. Yeah, a bit of a whip to it, that one. I enjoyed that. But yeah, look down, look, it's just the sea. It's just sea everywhere. So yeah, when you look down here, it is very much sea. It feels more exposed than the one at the end of Brighton Pier, I won't lie to you, and it definitely rides really, really well. The spin and the whip you get on it is fantastic. It genuinely is fantastic, and it does look really good. I mean, as I said, it is only a few years old, but you know, sea air, salt water, really does hammer these. It's something we've been told by, you know, our local parks down in Funland and Clarence that, you know, the rides do get an extra bit of battering when they're on the sea, and this thing is completely unprotected from the elements. And as you can see, it's quite choppy out there today. Quite choppy. Waltzer ready to go, carousel here, Dodgem's here. So we're going to get some off-ride footage as well of the rides we're not going on. We're going to try and get some off-ride footage of rides we're not going on. It's fairly busy here, to be fair. There's a few people kicking around. But Breakdance. Breakdance is one we want to ride next. Now, and there may not be a Huss Breakdance this one, but actually it's really quite good. As it's undergone some refurbishment since we sort of last saw it. We've got some new LEDs down the back. Looks like there's now holes at the back for lights as well. There's no lights on it at the moment. The centrepiece has gone, probably weighed quite a lot. The flags are gone, but it doesn't look like we've got some new strobe lights and some other new lighting, as well as speakers as well. It is very, very loud indeed. But this is actually quite a good little breakdance, or it certainly was last time I went on it. And it is something I want to get on today. Love it, absolutely love it. You see people flicking around on there, not many on there to be fair. So it's a very sidecore at the moment. The middle bits have spun up a bit. Outside slow down. I mean, don't get me wrong, these aren't as good as the ones that are seen on the circuit. However, when it picks up a bit of speed like this, hopefully it will do some whipping. So that's one of the stops today, this wonderful breakdance. I do like it. I do like to go on a breakdance. We don't have many in the UK that are much good. But this usually rides quite well. You are the it's breakdance time.
It's gonna be a slow one for you.
There we go. Gonna be a nice slow one for us. I worry that might actually be the case. Fingers crossed. See you younger. Could do some more upbeat music. We just come off a Radioactive into this. Now I've decided to sit in the middle, as you can see, to try and balance it a little bit better. Even though obviously you've got headrests here as well. I don't know how well that's going to pan out once we start moving, but we'll find out in a minute. We'll find out. But here is the breakdance. Aww. There's like a little slow dance we got going on here. I'm hoping this thing's got some power. Recent rides on King Loops. Exciter, Power Surge. I need something good from this. Got some nice smooth movement.
Here we go.
Here we go.
If you want it faster, everybody put your hands up in the air. Woo, woo. I'm waving like you just don't care. Tell me that you love me
too. Oh, here we go. There's some whip. Oh, yeah.
In the summer.
Oh. Oh.
As the light looks blue.
Oh, yes.
If you want me to spin your chair even more, you've got to bang on the floor.
Still got it, I'll tell you that now. It might look slow off ride, but on ride, this thing whips you all over the place. Even though the music doesn't particularly help the ride feeling here. Yeah, we do.
If you want to go one more time, everybody's got to scream. Here we go.
See what it's got. Oh, you can feel actually. You can feel the power kick in. Oh, yes you can. Yes you can. Oh, yeah, there we go. Miami ride Hard Rock, and again it's definitely had some new lighting since we've last seen it. Some lovely LED boards going up there, that vibrate quite nicely. The number one Hard Rock Miami on the end of the pier here. It's got a little bit of bounce around with people. It's got a nice backdrop, bright colours, looks really appealing with that lighting package. Now, do apologise for any wind noise that you can hear. We are on the end of a pier and I'm just with a GoPro. So I do want to make that one quite clear before anyone has to go at me in the comments about wind noise. I'll try and edit it out best I can. You know, just so that it's spinning around quite quickly. Good ferry Hybrid Ride Cycle, so the Breakdance. I have to say, looking at it off-ride, I was a bit concerned that maybe it didn't have it anymore, but it really has. We don't have many breakdances in the UK. I can only think of a few. I know Voodoo's Revenge Travels. That's all right, to be fair. It's not the best, but it's not the worst. It's sort of in the middle. We have Powder Kegs at Lightwater Valley, which is a Huss one, oddly enough, but isn't kind of, you know, up to the high standards that you'd expect a breakdance to be. Now, we have the Breakdance at South Shields as well, which came back onto the circuit, I think in 2020, which everyone flopped to ride. You know, I've ridden good Huss machines over the years, so I haven't been to ride that one yet, but I hear it's quite good. Obviously, there are great ones abroad. You know, watching one of Andy's that he went on the other day, which I thought the footage was sped up, was mental. But that actually is really, really good. Really genuinely good. It's got a good spin to it, a good whip. It's got a lovely variety. It's not just a case of switch it on and off it goes and watch the car spin. You know, they really do vary the turntable speed and the speed of the actual cars themselves on their turntable. And it works. You get some real violent whip moments. Then you get some more relaxing times of downtime before heading back again to a more violent whip motion. You can feel it. You can feel the motor when it kicks in. Love it, genuinely a really, really good breakdance ride. And I'm pleased it's still here as well. As I said, we don't get to get on very many. My top breakdance ride, believe it or not, is still Rodeo from Chessington. The way that thing was run when it was at Chessington was insane. I know people don't really think that because it's Chessington, but you gotta remember Chessington had this ride in the height of, you know, them being a thrill park, in the height of, you know, when the Juggler arrived, it was like, wow, what is that? It then moved as Rodeo, and they always started the cycle with the brakes on. And of course, got it at full speed before releasing the brakes. I've said this many times before, it whipped so hard, and then continued going as well. And of course, that ride unfortunately gave up, and Chessington gave up with the ride. It was then sold and is now traveling Europe. Now, I know there are good ones around. I know the Decadance as well is supposed to be very, very good. But thus far, that's the best one I've ridden. And I've ridden a few. There used to be quite a lot of travelling ones in the UK. We've had ones at Winter Wonderland as well. Nothing yet tops Rodeo. I'm sure it will one day, though. I'm sure it will one day. But there's Hard Rock. We're going to go and get some footage of the coaster in action. Someone just went on the Sky Swing as well. I did unfortunately miss that. And then, yeah, you know, we've done some rides. I had a good laugh, to be honest with you. You can see the sun is starting to come down here on the South Pier. We'll get a view of the coaster as it goes round. There are people getting on it. Really impressed, to be fair, with the crazy coaster. Still riding really, really well. Definite whip on the corners. Oh, we said before it's probably our best one we went on, however, riding a Twister at Lightwater Valley, which is sadly no longer there, was definitely the best ride we've had. That video is on our channel if you want to see our last ride on that, which was a day, you know, a day before the accident, the unfortunate accident had on it. And of course, that ride has now been sold, repainted, and is on the fair circuit. But this is a good one. This is genuinely a really good one. Crazy coaster, it starts spinning as it goes around there. Yeah, cracking ride, cracking. So, South Pier, Blackpool, always very popular, even with the Pleasure Beach just over there. Always very popular, and I'm pretty sure whoever owns this one also owns the Central Pier. I'm sure they're co-owned, with the North Pier being owned by someone completely different. There are rides on both, as we said. We won't be doing any rides at Central Pier, but look out for the vlog. We're going to be doing a walk around of that one very, very shortly, oddly enough, but it will appear on the channel in the next few days. Have you been to South Pier? Have you experienced a breakdance? What is everyone's thought on that breakdance? I actually think it's quite good, but it'd be interesting to see what you think of it. Crazy coaster is really good, and I forgot as well, there is a log flume at the front, which used to be here. The log flume used to sit here before the park bought the crazy coaster. They then moved that to the front. We'll try and get a shot of that on the way out, and I'll add it on to the end of the vlog. So there are people going on the Sky Screamer. Just look at this height restriction. I reckon that's about 1.1 metres. I've never seen one under 1.5. I reckon that's 1.1. It's tiny. But yeah, here they go. Here they go. I can't believe how small you have to be. So that is £20 a ride. It shoots you 200 feet in the air. Fairly standard, to be honest, for a bungee sort of ride. But yeah, I've never seen one with that low height restriction. I mean, it just, that's got to be 1.1 metres. That's lower than the breakdance to go on this Sky Screamer, which is staggering when you think about it. That's bungee at full capacity, and off they go. Oh. Just reminds me a bit of Ice Blast, really. You know, they say it's 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. You've got to put it in perspective, stealth's a bit quicker. Ice Blast is shooting you up about the same height, maybe slightly less, just as quick, and then it's, you know, a relaxing jaunt back to the ground. But yeah, Sky Screamer, awarded traction of the year. Not sure who by, but awarded traction of the year. Certainly looks good. Certainly seems popular on South Pier. We are now going to go and have a look for the Log Flume. So I wasn't going blind. I didn't completely miss it. There is no Log Flume here. Comment below, has the Log Flume been here this summer? I genuinely don't know. Genuinely haven't got a clue. But South Pier, great time, great time. Great to get on the coaster, great to get on the breakdance, great to see people still having fun at the end of October. The seas may be choppy here in Blackpool, but it has not stopped people coming out and enjoying themselves. But yeah, let us know. Where did the Log Flume go? Can't help but admire the view here. But thank you for joining us here from South Pier. My name's Adam. This has been UK Theme Parks. Keep an eye on the channel. We've got plenty of things going on throughout the month of October. If this is up quite late, I'm sure there'll be some things in November as well. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time.